So what are we doing today?
We're going driving with our second period driving group today.
Are we good to go?
I think we're good.
Are you sure?
I'm positive.
What other things do you check for when you check around the car?
I check and see what way the tires are turned, if they need air, and make sure there's no dead bodies behind me.
Now, how do you judge a tire?
Well, they should look a little bit like this, but not like this. Because, you know, then they're flat, you know.
Okay, we don't need gas.
So when we're driving, what are some of the things that you look for in your drivers?
Well, first thing, they're told if they break the law, they lose a letter grade. So make sure you come to complete stops. Make sure you use your turn signals. Can't break the speed limit, even though a lot of times the police will give you more than 5 miles an hour. They don't have to. And then if you're going 36 and 35, they can give you a ticket.
That's true. That is true.
And that shift in weight's what the police will look for to make sure you've come to a complete stop.
We always see these signs that say 15 miles an hour in a school zone, when children are present. When are children present?
Well, we asked the police that because we had the same question. Does it mean when they're visible outside or present in the school building? And they said, at least in Lincoln County, they go with present in the school building. And the judge will prosecute based on that. So we figure it better be safe, you know. If it's a Monday through Friday, 8 to 3, better slow down. In West Virginia, if it's not posted on a road that has
two lanes,
yellow lines, white lines like this, it's 55 unless marked. But another rule is, like, if you're turning off that other road that was 45 onto this road and it's not a sign, then that's the ruling speed limit still. I think one of the biggest things is falling too close. We use a 4-second rule, and we don't have a car, but imagine there's a car in front of us. As soon as it passed that telephone pole right there, you should be able to count 4 seconds before you get to that telephone pole. That way, if they stop suddenly, you have enough time to get your own vehicle stopped or search for an exit route to avoid hitting them or something else. And most of us know when we look in the rearview mirrors, cars don't follow that. They follow much closer, and we often want to hit the brakes and remind them, hey, we're up here, back off me. So that's a big one. Another one, and most of the people who have already been driving, kind of tears them up because they get in the habit of doing the one-handed drive, but you should have your hands somewhere above the 9 and 3, both hands. 10 and 2 is recommended. That way, if you hit something and all that, one hand slips, you still got control with the other hand. That's always a big issue there. It's real easy to lose control and realize that in bad weather, rain, especially snow, but even just rain, slow down a little bit, because you hit just a quarter inch of water and you could lose control of your vehicle if you start hydroplaning.
So how was your driving experience today?
It was pretty good, a little rainy.
Any bit nerve-wracking today?
Not really.
Not even with the camera pointed in your face?
Nah. We'll be right back.